the Satyr's just helping clear through these waves a little faster. Well, top lane, Puppy. Oh, that's why he's using the tangos only for the moment. DY is not giving it up. Is he actually going for the courier? Only two hits. Courier turns around.
He's going to pay the price for that one, I think.
Deliver the wards. Oh, is he? Reactive armor charges are coming down. There's your movement speed. Chain away will not work. Mid one, but he'll try and do have an influence of his own as Yang, Shard locked in. Of course, who's really locked in here with who? Yang is copying a lot of damage. But with PYW arriving, how much more have you got to give Puppy? That's to burn his last magic missile. The DGen Aura slowing down Puppy. And Matumba is really wondering if he wants to get involved in this. Nisha, good avalanche. Shards from mid one, try and block Nisha out, but oh, that'll be problematic. The Viper's poison will sting him through. A little bit of trouble. There's a magic missile still available, trying to wait out the max duration of the shards. And now Matumba can move over. Of course, there is the avalanche to create some space, but Matumba, he's here for the kill, and he'll claim it on Yang. Like, against that Elder Titan, feels like life is going to get a lot harder before it gets better. Nisha trying to line up, does not have Shackle, but the avalanche and toss. Nisha has enough life to survive, and Tiny, focus fire down. Nisha will take the kill, and he can even get the stack. Yeah, he does. Both of the stacks, in fact.
Wow.
Purification, Yang in trouble once again. That stomp, fraction of a second too late from DY, the Troll Warlord. But now he's surrounded by three heroes. Ori rotates in, Eurus is here. I don't even think he hit the ground. Not in one piece. Managed to find some kind of combination with heroes, but just leaving Puppy and Matumba alone up on the top. Matumba, careful, the stomp. He's going to connect. He's healing as quick as he possibly can. Now the magic missile out from Puppy with Avalanche and the help from Eurus. But Tumman, waveforms on cooldown for 3 more seconds. He needs to live a little bit longer, but that time is just not there for him. And VG Gaming with 4 heroes on the top lane coming to the 10-minute mark. This feels like a broken record for this tournament. They will go for yet another kill. This one's going to be on Puppy. They will claim the top outpost. They will lose the bottom for it, however. And Zai does not want to give this Omni Knight any kind of space, but he can't push the issue too hard. They fortify to keep both creep waves alive. It's the catapult waves underneath the tower. And Zai, man, you got 3 heroes on you. It's a big whirling death, but still his own death, forcing rotations of VG to the bottom lane to find these kills. I have to ask the question, is this all intentional? Is this, like, is he okay to die here?
I don't think so.
Space for the other two cores?
No, it's just not enough space.
They're going
to
mid.
So fast.
DY trapped in. Nisha with the focus fire is bringing down this ET so quickly. But now mid one trapped on the wrong side. He'll snowball back out towards the range creep. A lot of damage from Ori. Sees the shackle coming and easily sidesteps it.
I think he just knows he needs to participate in this game. Lincoln's is really only good against the Viper ultimate, so you'd only be doing it for the stats and the regen. He wants to participate in this game early because of the rough start, I think, that his Timbersaw's had.
Smoke on smoke. We'll play a Ring of Ring of Rosie. Puppy's the one in the mid lane.
Diffuse,
but it's the bottom lane where Team Secret are heading, so they want to try and kill off Yang, who's been pretty, like, manning up against Zai while in the mid lane. He'll say goodbye to Puppy, but the rebuttal. Core 4 support with the focus fire damage. They have more than enough Yang to fall. But the mid-tier 1 tower, VG Gaming, looking to push in, even fortifying the wave. Really not as effective as it used to be, and the Shard block actually holds in Eurus. The VG Gaming have 4 heroes here in the mid lane. They're ready to fight, but Team Secret don't even want that. They're just clearing the wave.
And that tag team plus the Wind Ranger ultimate, we talked about it multiple times, but that is so much damage.
And it really feels like Secret are playing for their timings. Zai once again, he doesn't have the hood. Let's see if he can survive this one. Whirling death, chain away. Toss, you know he's going to come back to that tier 1 tower right on top of Ori. And Zai, another chain out, but those reactive armor charges nowhere near enough life to survive. But hey, he survived the toss.
He did indeed. He did land this time. If they want to, on the side of Vici. I mean, can Secret just get out? I think they should.
They got what they came for. They came for the tier 1 tower, now it's backing up for the 15-minute bounties. Oh, wow. Shards flying forward, toss back, but Tumberman waveforms. Dodges the stomp just at the right time, able to one charge up quickly. Shackle will fly forward from Nisha. Latches to the one tree.
That's tough, right? Because Wind Rangers attacks a bunch of times. Doesn't really benefit that much from the crit.
Well, mid one cannot help Zai. Even though he wants to, he's already walking away. Head snowball, so he could have bought a little bit of extra time, but decided against it. Creep wave will arrive. Puppy gets rid of the early vision. Nisha just wants to power shot through the wave, looks for a shackle to latch the troll wall, can't get it, the shards, they're all just locked in, and mid one has to snowball quickly, just to buy a little bit of extra time, but he's going towards PYW, and you knew he was dead. Urus was waiting for him. The Morphling's taking the tier 2 tower in the bottom lane fortification from VG Gaming. We'll be able to slow this up. The Morphling farming underneath the Radiant Orbs and Sentry.
Mid one has a Desolator on support. Tusk
Tiny's got Blink. 600, 700. Okay, waveforms away. Good reaction from Matumba.
Ranger going for a BKB of his own on Nisha.
Got Zai. He's probably feeling a little bit more confident now that he has the Yule Scepter. Avalanche to begin with. That stomp. A little bit off target. Zai actually Yulesing and doing some damage into Tiny. It's because support's coming in. Puppy will arrive. He can swap him back out to safety. In fact, he swaps the troll Warlord further up so he can't run away. The ET splitter kicks in as well, but you will see a dodge out from Team Secret. More Shark from slowdowns, but Urus doesn't seem to care. The adaptive strike slows him up. Puppy once again with a swap. Now the snowball forward. They are just trying to bring down this troll. They're able to succeed. DY stop trying to create more space, but he cannot move away. The Shark room was on top of him. And Team Secret, then they fight hard. They fight repositioning, but they come out on top with a 3-1 trade. Nisha's pushing it. He's trying to get the last bit of money in for his BKB. The Team Secret will be knocking at this thing for a good 10 minutes. Top lane. Oh, we're TPing in once again. Walrus Punch trying to keep Omni Knight in control. DY E-Blade pop him in the front lines. But then again, the damage output with the Avalanche. Team Secret, I don't know if they're totally ready for that one, but maybe they got a little bit of fight back. Matumba trying to get some space. Urus with the spin. He's getting his own life back. The power shot. Nisha just playing from the back lines. VG Gaming, they never reach the Wind Ranger. A quick shackle. More damage output. Not going to come. Power shot. Little off target.
Another last game.
I definitely want to keep a closer eye on Zai. You understand why. Well, also the mid lane. Snowball. He's heading towards Urus. You are a long way from home, mid one. Team Secret left him. They are on the way. Wave of Terror gives a good reveal. Looking for a good shackle as well. Unable to connect. VG Gaming leaving the pit for Tumberman. That's a good E-Blade pop onto the Vibrant. Even better shackle. Troll, Omni Knight locked together. The Stomp, the Sleep is buying some more time. Now the GA's back up. The ET splitter. Team Secret. Their ears are ringing, but Viper is down. Wind Ranger still battling from the side. Inside of Roshan. The focus fire did the work. PYW tried to get there in time for his own stuns, but it just didn't do anywhere near enough. BS. The only one to die, but that's the one Team Secret want to die. Yang on the wrong side of the river. And Team Secret, you'll thank VG for their hard work dropping Roshan down. Tiny, oh, YOLO play. The snowball forward is a lot of damage, but Roshan's not dead. Now it's going to be Tiny the one to die. Roshan be claimed too. Team Secret is all going their way now. Three, the double damage of Morphling. It's itching to do the damage. Fortification must be forced. At least it can clean up the creep wave nice and quickly. Tempestor, not a healthy man either. Keeping the spirit on top of him. Puppy will swap him out, but look who just goes straight in. Morphling, quickly broken. Avalanche and the toss. They keep him up. Matumba, remember, he's got the Aegis Immortal. So even though they break him now, there could be a follow-up. Great shackle on from the catapult towards the Tiny, but they want to go for more. Puppy swaps himself out. The sacrificial lamb. He just wants the rest of Team Secret out. That's the only reason he wants to sacrifice himself like this. Zai with the Sharkum, slow him down, but they want the big man. They want Matumba man. He's a 6-1, 6 kill if he can get it. But then again, Zai, he combos with the E-Blade proc. A buyback will come in quickly as VG Gaming had that shrine for a close support. Reinforcements to the front lines. Another shackle! Nisha with the focus fire! He needs Maelstrom procs with a power shot. He knows not to battle through the GA, which is a physical attack, but now it's worn off. DY will go down. Nisha uses the last BKB to get out there. Tuskar as well has no TP scroll, so mid one tribute to Arteezy.
Not a fan necessarily, but
oh, Puppy swaps down, going after the troll Warlord, but the BKB will protect him, and now Puppy really trapped in no man's land. Goes down quickly, there was no save. Tiny. Put him to the test. Quick D ward. Toss him back over. Snowball able to dodge out the stomp, but there's five heroes here to kill off mid one.
That's so space.
Put back down to 3.5 position. Comes close, they end up breaking an avalanche forward. This will be a huge pickoff if they can claim Wind Ranger, but she gets the BKB off, looking for a shackle, unable to latch, however. The VG Gaming resetting up. Tusk is now making his way back over to the fight. And they just want to push forward. VG Gaming, E-Blade, throwing out with the magic missile of Puppy. Urus! just gets wiped out by Zai. The stomp will create a little bit more space with the shackle. They know timing is there. Shards will now fly forward. Anyone bring detection? Anyone with dust? Not required anymore. Tiny's come back out of the invis with the glimmer cape. Both down for 2 minutes.
He had BKB ult, Toby. He could have done a lot of different things to live there, but he just didn't expect that amount of burst damage coming out.
He could have not walked up the hill.
That's
look
you.
At Zai. He's just like, all right, boys, let's keep it going. Yang now becomes the new target. E-Blade fly out. He gave the Heavenly Grace over towards the Viper to try and save his life. The ET splitter able to catch out all three heroes, but Matumba just going ham against EY. But the Pyvex coming in from the Tiny as well as the Troll. This is going to be expensive defense. Troll Warlord trying to do as much work as he can. 100 HP, he needs more lifesteal, but now it's a dieback! Huge for Team Secret! And they're looking for more. Tiny down a little bit too far, but Nisha not in time for the Shackle. It was on cooldown. And with all this time they've taken a battle, there's two couriers. One is obviously better than two, watching for Roshan to spawn. He'll be up in 15 seconds, but no Troll for a minute and a half. Secret might think about breaking base.
Yeah, he's their core frontliner.
Tiny, good toss back, able to catch out Pumpy. They'll kill him off pretty quickly. Lotus Orb can't protect him. He will, however, have the Vengeful Spirit. Well, the Vengeful Spirit that will back up with the rest of Team Secret. They see that Roshan's alive. They don't need to force the issue anymore.
That is some serious economic damage. The shovel is off cooldown.
Mjolnir up. And a good catch with a toss back. Timpasaur, oh, he gets the Yule Scepter up in towards the air. BS looking to swap him back out. Now Matumba jumping forward. Timpa does die, but he'll buy back quickly into this fight. A full retreat out. Ori swap back into the middle of Team Secret. Goodbye to your Viper with the stomp. DY, he's only buying time, but Matumba was protected by his own BKB. Puppy low on life. DY just wants to finish him with all that bonus damage, but he can't even do that. Puppy lives and then shovels. 44 HP he'll survive on. And Tiny caught in no man's land. Another Yule Scepter. Zai has just been the playmaker this game. Always setting Secret up.
Squad. A ton of men has the Aegis. The Satanic is online, as you mentioned. They're looking good here to potentially take multiple lanes of Rags.
It's like you take three position from like from every aura that you'd get to item and item enableization. So they do claim the mid Rags. No buybacks being used because they don't have them. Down to bottom lane, Nisha. They just want the two lanes of racks. The Aghanim Tempest coming out in the Courier will take a little bit longer. Waveforming to dodge the stomp. Zai will sleep for the moment, but it won't matter. They're taking two lanes of racks. Still 28 seconds before Tiny is up. But with Viper respawning, Team Secret, do they back up? Do they look to fight? There's an E-Blade pop. Troll Warlord, he looks good. A purification will give him a little bit more life. BKB, Matumba just going in ham. Maybe not enough life to do this one, but he doesn't care. Remember, he's got Aegis as well as Satanic. Even if you do manage to bring Morphling down low, he's going to bring his life back up again. Nisha's a different case. Cheese is available for him, and he's backing out. Fine. He's on cooldown for 2 minutes, but you've got Tiny underneath an Observer Ward.
So much damage. So, no rush. They're chilling.
Well, Zai still frontliner. You want to push it. Tier 3 tower doesn't last long. Power Shot connects over on 3, but my god, they just go straight in towards the Elder Titan. Trying to kill him off quickly. Shackle unable to latch from Nisha. The break on the Timber Sword. This is the best opportunity they've got. He's pretty deep in, but the Timber Chain pulling Zai further away from the fight. But Talmud, a lot of damage, but hey! He'll get it straight back again. The ET splitter snapping back in. At least Tuskers have mid one to go down. Puppy, he's falling down quickly too. Same thing for Zai. Throw him up and drop him back down. Triple kill for Urus. They lose the last lane of Rax on top, so Megas are here for Team Secret. 80 seconds.
Final stretch for VG. Can they bring it home? They're running out of time before the supports are coming alive.
BTs are up on Ori. He's got a TP to a creep, however, so he's got to be careful about the timing of this.
Fortification still up for Secret as well.
Yep. 66 seconds on the clock. Nice shackle. PYW in way too deep with the E-Blade pop. It's not enough to kill him off just yet. Matalman still looking for a good target. They're just tossing him around, but Tiny, he doesn't have the life to survive this VG gaming. They're not feeling it anymore. And with Tiny dead, he's down for 70 seconds. And Ori, he never BT'd to the front line to be part of this.
You kind of got to respect that he went for the kill, but a little over-ambitious there.
They want to fight.
Did not have buyback during that time, so that would have been crucial.
MKB just got given to Troll Warlord. He's got an Invis Rune. Where's that Gem of Truesight? It's not on mid one. It's not on Matumba. They don't see anything. Is Puppy putting down Sentry Wards? Now they see him! Hit the stuns! He got the BKB off! Dodges at least the end of the shotgun blast! The BKB has been burned. Viper BTing herself towards the front lines as well. The GA is going to wear off in a second. My god! Ahri! Oh, he doesn't exist anymore. I don't think BG's chances will live with it unless you can get Zlamuras through this. Going big and not wanting to go home.
They already just called the GG.
They did?
Yeah, that might have been a bit preemptive. They forced some buybacks. They gave themselves a win condition, but Viper didn't even look like a hero in that last fight. He evaporated. Man, so much damage.
You want to switch to the cameras of VG. There's a small little discussion at the end of it. It's like, okay, guys, like, was that it? Was that done? Like,
was that a bit out of frustration?
Did troll actually happen?